operated a store on Ossington and Queen. I tried to introduce the concept of people bringing in their recyclable clothes that they no longer wanted to see if I can reconstruct something new. That was a challenge, especially coming from a city like Los Angeles, where I worked with this fantabulous woman, Shireen. She collected vintage garments, and her specialty was in making wedding gowns and gowns for the awards. And I thought, wow, coming back to Canada, this would be a great business to follow in. And it was very difficult to find a clientele who wanted to shop for that kind of stuff. I found that people often came, they wanted to buy something that was in the store, already made. They wanted to try it on and leave the same day with something that they can wear that night. Today, here we are. We still wanting to educate on this matter. We're going to focus on the how-tos of recycling and repurposing clothing by showing a few at-home projects. Did you know that blue jeans are the world's most popular garment? Evidence supports that it is estimated that 46 to 56% of Canadians wear jeans almost every day, washing them only after two wears.
My name's Lisa Ertl, and I research microfibers and their effects on the environment. When we look at microfibers in the environment, we see a lot of natural fibers that have an indigo dye. And what this tells us is that these fibers are coming from our blue jeans.
Do you know that the microfibers that we use in man-made fabrics, when washed in the laundry, release as much plastic into the water as 50 billion plastic bottles? Scary thought.
Hi, I'm Norman Rathi from MetTech. We're in the business of trying to recycle waste textiles and solve the waste textile challenge. Microfibers are basically when you wash your clothes, small amounts of it come off. We're not collecting those. So you need technology downstream, ideally, at the sewage treatment plant to remove it.
Hello, my name is Diane Sachs. I am an environmental lawyer. I was the last environmental commissioner of Ontario. Fashion affects climate change and climate pollution, but it also affects the destruction of ecosystems and wildlife due to the destruction of biodiversity, and particularly through water use and toxins.
The leather and denim industries are probably the two most toxic when it comes to the use of chemicals and the pollution of water. We don't make clothes in Canada as much as we used to, but we dispose of our clothes here. We actually put about 500,000 tons of textiles into the landfill in Canada alone every year. Globally, there's 92 million tons of textiles that go into the landfill. Every second of every day, a garbage truck full of textiles are either being dumped into landfill or incinerated. And then there's also methane that's released. So it's causing greenhouse gas emissions.
I'm proposing a sort of a complete solution. What MetTech is doing is it's taking some inorganic science and applying it to organic materials. We can sort it using chemistry and physics. reason why I thought of using the Blue Box program is you're going to encourage more recycling of the material. What it does is it eliminates textiles going to landfill.
One solution that we know of is that washing machine filters work. So we did an experiment where we tested different types of devices, one that's a filter that filters out all the water as it leaves your washing machine. And in the lab, we found that they capture up to 90% of microfibers each time you wash your clothing. So these fibers are captured in people's homes before they enter the water and into aquatic ecosystems.
As we talked about earlier, we're going to start on a very simple at-home project to recycle and reuse your old jeans with lining the bottom with a durable elastic band. So you pin it, stretch it, flap the denim over, pin it again. It's very simple, anyone can do it.
Hello, I am Dennis Adamides. I'm the owner of House of Vintage Toronto. We try to stick to 100% cotton jeans. When you're talking about 100% cotton, usually things like this do actually last a long time if you take care of them. On this particular pair of pants, we have a nice train track, as they're called here, that goes all the way up the side seam, which is indicative of vintage denim.
Another pair of denim jeans that have been recycled, and so here is my tool for today. Removing everything stitch by stitch. I'm trying to conserve as much fabric as possible so there is least amount of waste, because once we start cutting, that's the microfibers that we throw away.
I got into the recycle industry because I like cool clothing and I like antiques. And it's kind of an interesting merger of the two, and it's beautiful. There's a carbon footprint that we're trying to reduce, and wearing vintage actually does that.
Buying high quality things that last a long time and using them completely up is enormously better than buying a whole batch of cheap things. And fashion has been really one of the real culprits. Responsibility for what happens to this when I'm finished with it. It's a different mindset, but we can still have a really good life, in many ways better lives, by taking seriously how much of the world we're entitled to use up. And it shouldn't be more than our fair share.
In 20 years from now, 30 years from now, hopefully sustainability won't even be a word. It'll just be fashion.
There's a lot of magic happens in the shop when someone finds something that's totally cool. And that's the kind of thing that we're hopefully going to get back into at some point.
Our water is so precious, and we rely on it for so many things. There's many reasons to protect it and stop polluting with microfibers and other contaminants.
If the carbon won't kill us, certainly the contaminated water will.
Cercando siempre el amor.